looking for room. Picked up a few yards and picked up 4 of those 5 yards back. That'll bring up 2nd down and 11 for the Tigers. Keeper by Graham. That's a pick up about 5 yards. Now bring up 3rd down and a 6. Bring up the 4th down, kicking down for the Tigers. First down for Arabia on their own 35. A handoff. Was able to get back to the line of scrimmage. No gain on that. Back looking, and he is knocked in the back. Nowhere to go for Juice Shaw. And that'll bring up 3rd down. And 3rd down and 14. Thank you. on the play. Referee stops the play. More likely they are going to be against the offense. And it is. That'll back the Rams up. Draws back, looking. Got a man in the flat. And picked up about 2 yards, but that'll bring up fourth down. The Tigers hold. Kicking down for the Rams. Good high kick. He's taking a Ram bounce. And stopped there at the 36-yard line where the Tigers would take over first down. No score in the first quarter. Kobe, and he is caught in the backfield. He lost of about 2 yards. Second and 12, 11 for the Tigers. Looking, finds a man in the middle, incomplete. Bringing third down and 11 for the Tigers. Looking, throws it over the top. Not enough for Dudley to get to over there. Kicking down for the Tigers, fourth down. Bounce. Flag on the play. Let's see who that is. improvement on the offense. Fine by the Rams. They kick over on the 31-yard line of the Tigers. First down. Motion on the offense. That'll take him back 5 yards. That'll make it second down and about 14 for first. Looking for running room. He's down to the outside looking for block. And he was laid on the side. Pick up about 7-8 yards. Bringing up third down and about 5-6 for first. And screen to the outside. Flags come out. Motion again, that'll drop them back 5 more yards. Thank you. 1 yard line. And we have another flag. And we will kick it again. Back to Rams up 5 more yards. And that great punt was just wiped out. First down. Thank you. another flag. First down without a snap. That'll be first and 10 at the 10 for the Rams. The Dukem back looking over and he overthrew him out of the end zone. The second down is 10 for the Rams at the 11-yard line. Trying to break out. Pick up about 4 yards. That'll bring up third down and about 6 yards. Looking for a man. He's trying to make it in. He get close to a first down. Did he get an end zone? First down. No. It is a first down. First and goal for the Rams from half yard line. Thank you. for the defeated. Short kick. Good field position for the Tigers. They will kick over at midfield. First down. There's a flag now. Look. There's another flag. That's a 15-yard mark ball for the Tigers. McCoy, he's around the end looking for a hole. One man to beat. McCoy down the line to the 40, the 30, the 20. And he is pushed out of bounds at about the 15, 13 yards. Oh, 50-yard run by McCoy. Played at the 13, first and 10. McCoy again on the handoff, looking for room. He was stacked up after about 2 yards. About a 1 yard gain. It'll be third down and about 6. And it's going to be about 8. That was going to he didn't get out of the backfield. Holding on the Tigers, so that's going to back them up. It's like 2 steps forward and 3 steps backward for the Tigers. Kristen Whitmore. Oh, Tiger to go and put an extra point. Up and good. With 1:24 left in the first quarter, Tigers 7 and the Rams 8. First down for the Rams on the 31-yard line. Able to move the ball for about 1 yard. And that'll bring up second down and 9. Four and a half. Going up and over the top. Could not get his man. But there is a flag. Pass interference on the Tigers, and that will give the Rams a first down. Gives the Rams a first down at the 38-yard line. With 20 seconds left in the first quarter. By the Tigers. That'll do it for the first quarter. What a long quarter, but we will be right back for the second. With the Rams leading the Tigers 8-7.
Let me know if I can help you with anything.
Just looking. I only buy local and sustainable, so.
Oh, well, that shirt's not local. You should be wearing cotton. Georgia's a major supplier of cotton worldwide, so if you'd like to buy local to support Georgia, buying cotton's a great place to start. It's renewable and sustainable, naturally.
Thanks.
Now that's a polyester fiber made of oil.
By the way, where's your dressing room?
At Regions Bank, we're here to listen to your needs, and we'll customize a plan to help you reach your financial goals. Our service to Georgia goes beyond banking to creating more inclusive prosperity in our communities. From education to financial wellness to economic development, we're working to level the playing field so more people can succeed and our communities can thrive.
Thank you.
down the line. Flags all over, and Mosley, 54, fell out of position. That'll be a first and 15 for the Tigers.
Yeah, but I ain't think they're calling nothing. Back in the day,
if anyone lost a Tennessee license, pick it up at the gate. Also, if you picked up the phone at the gate by mistake, please turn it in to the gate. Again, if you are missing your Tennessee license, it is at the gate. And if you picked up a phone by mistake, please return it to the gate. Please check your phone, make sure it is yours. That'll be second down.
They already made the announcement. They already said it.
McCoy on the run. He brings it to the outside. Got some room. He's looking for a hole through the line. And still moving. Pushed the ball all the way up to the 30-yard line. First down, tight. Looking, kicked it up, got a man open. Number four, and it goes. touchdown. Christian Whitmore's second touchdown of the night. For the extra point. There is going to be encroachment, looks like on the Rams. You are missing a Tennessee license. It is at the gate. If you picked up a phone by mistake at the gate, please return it. Top to the outside, up to the 37-yard line.
Thank you.
They're looking to do a cool hit. And that's going to be a target, it looks like. And that was a helmet to helmet hit. Mark off giving the Rams the first down in the Tigers territory. That pass went for about 5 yards. First down. Another flag. And that should mark off the first down for the Rams without running the play. Looking at you, he was a flip through, got a man, and just missed it. Doing. That'll bring up second down. down there and do it, we were able to flip through that particular sack. Looking, he is a hole, and he is able to pick up about 5 yards. Then play it down for Tucker. Looking, got a man wide open. Did he get it in his zone? This is a marking it right at the half yard line. First down. Snap again, didn't do anything. He was able to get it back to the line of scrimmage with a whole host of Tigers on his back.
Get into the center! Come on, center! Get into the center! The 1 yard line! Get the damn shotgun!
Thank you.
second down and goal. Tripped up right there at the line. And third and goal for the Rams. That's going to mark them back, by the way.
That's what I was just saying.
Now you got to throw the ball.
Back to the 20-yard line, bringing up fourth down and goal. Over at the 20-yard line, first down. McCoy to the outside, down to the 23rd, looking to break down the line. Pushed out of bounds at about the 42-yard line. A run of about 23 yards. First down. Boy, looking to the outside again, and he is back down.
Go get that, coach! Go get that! Don't wait for him! Oh, he runs the sweep!
With 3:30 left in the first half, the score is still 14-8, Tucker. And then movement on the offense.
Let's go, Big Blue! Three down!
McCoy. Looking, trying to get through the hole. They pick up a couple of yards. Got a man right to the outside, the main 40 looking, and he caught there at the 40-yard line. Another 30-yard pass and run. First down, Tigers. First down for the Tigers. Tigers are trying to move down the field with less than 2 minutes. 2 minutes in the game. Timeout, Tigers. Ball's out of here. Around the end, got a man, steps out of bounds, pick up about 7 yards.
First down
for the Rams. 55 seconds left in the game. In the first half, anyway. Good night, get around, number 25. That was Damian Davis on the tackle. We got another flag motion on the offense. That'll bite the next time. There's 17 seconds left in the first half. Looking for room.
Yeah. Out of bounds. They did it first time. First down. Yeah, kept on running.
In 9 seconds, we got one more play. And that'll do it for the first half. So, go fill up, get some chicken wings, and we'll be back for an exciting second half.
Let me know if I can help you with anything.
Just looking. I only buy local and sustainable, so.
Oh, well, that shirt's not local. You should be wearing cotton. Georgia is a major supplier of cotton worldwide, so if you'd like to buy local to support Georgia, buying cotton's a great place to start. It's renewable and sustainable, naturally.
Thanks.
And that's a polyester fiber made of oil, by the way.
Where's your dressing room?
At Regions Bank, we're here to listen to your needs, and we'll customize a plan to help you reach your financial goals. Our service to Georgia goes beyond banking to creating more inclusive prosperity in our communities. From education to financial wellness to economic development, we're working to level the playing field so more people can succeed and our communities can thrive.
Good evening, everyone, and welcome to Senior Night. Tonight we honor 47 of our graduating seniors on the boys' football, cheer, and band programs here at Tucker High School. Now, as I call their names and recognize just some of their many accomplishments, each senior and their invited family members will walk on the field and pose for a photo before being escorted off. Now, let's begin. Approaching the 50-yard line is Janaya Bailey, head football manager. She is escorted by her grandmother Dietrich and cousin. She has served as the Tucker football manager for 4 years, while also serving as basketball manager, an assistant trainer, and participating in the yearbook. After graduation, Janaya plans to attend Alabama State University and major in sports medicine. Next, we have Anaya McClendon Davis. She is escorted by her mom, Sequoia, and cousin, Josiah. She has been the assistant manager for Tucker football for 1 year. She has worked with the Young Physicians Initiative with Dr. Wagner. She plans to attend Winston-Salem State University and study pediatric oncology. Next, we have Hassan Sykes. He's escorted tonight by his parents, his grandparents, and siblings. Hassan has played football for 10 years, including 4 at Tucker. Hassan has a 4.2 GPA and is a member of the Tucker High School track and field team. After graduation, she is committed to attend the University of Florida on a full scholarship and major in marketing. Next, we have Dallas Kelly. He's escorted by his mother, Sonia, and his father, Nataro, and his sister. Dallas has played football at Tucker High School for 4 years and is also a member of the varsity baseball team. After graduation, he plans to play football at HBCU while majoring in engineering. Next, we have Jordan McCoy. escorted by his mother, Nazaree, his father, Harrell, and his stepmother, Latoya. Jordan had played football all 4 years at Tucker High School, and the last being two. He's a member of the track and field team. He plans to go to college and major in business. Christian Whitmore. He is escorted by his mother, Chauncey, and his father, Chris. Christian has played football for 7 years, including 4 here at Tucker. Christian is a member of the track and field team, where he is the state champ in the 200 meters. He has a 3.2 GPA, and after graduation plans to attend a 4-year college. He will be a dual athlete in track and football while majoring in business. Jamar Graham, our quarterback. He is escorted by his mother, Akeisha, and his father, Jamil, and his siblings. Jamar has played football since he was 4 years old and has played at Tucker for 2 years. He is a 3-sport athlete, also playing baseball and basketball. After high school, he plans to attend college and prayerfully continue his football career all the way to the NFL, with the ultimate goal of owning a sports agency or facility. Chase Reeves, he's escorted by his mother, Rashida, and his sister, Amaya. Chase has played football for 5 years and also plays varsity baseball. After graduation, he plans to play football in college while growing his clothing brand and breeding dogs. Christian C.J. Jackson. He's escorted by his mother Kay, sister Zoe, and grandmother Karen. C.J. has played football for 10 years, including 2 years at Tucker. After graduation, he plans to continue his football career at LSU, majoring in aviation. Kendall Beard. It's escorted by her mom, Sheree, and father, Brandon, and siblings. Kendall has played football for 11 years, including 1 year at Tucker. Kendall is also a member of the track and field and wrestling team. He has a 3.2 GPA and plans to play football at D1 College, majoring in business management and finance. Up next, Andrew Varner Jr. He's escorted by his mother, Angela, and his father, Andrew Sr. Andrew has played football for 9 years, including 2 at Tucker. After graduation, Andrew plans to attend college and a trade school because he ultimately wants to be an entrepreneur. Up next is Tariq Johnson. He's escorted by his mother, Tasha, and his siblings. Tariq has played football for 12 years, including 2 at Tucker. After graduation, Tariq plans to play football in college and major in computer engineering. Up next, Rashad Martin. He's escorted by his mother, Sharmika, and father, Richard, and his grandmother, Sherry. Rashad has played football for 12 years, including 1 year at Tucker, and he also plays basketball. After graduation, Rashad plans to play football in college and major in business management. Malik Randall. He's escorted by his mother, Crystal, and his father, Devin. Malik has played football for 8 years, including 3 years at Tucker. He's a member of the wrestling team. After graduation, Malik plans to go to college and study psychology. Let's wish Shandarius Harris a happy birthday today on his senior night. He's escorted by his mother, LaShonda. Shandarius has played football for 6 years, including all 4 at Tucker. After graduation, Shandarius plans to attend Southern University and major in criminal justice, minor in business management, and get his real estate license to be a broker. Up next, Damian DJ Davis Jr. He's escorted by his mother Sharia and sister Andre. DJ has played football for 4 years, including 2 with Tucker. After graduation, DJ plans to go to college, majoring in business administration and entrepreneurship before opening his own business. Quincy Cox. He's escorted by his mother Stephanie, father LaQuincy Sr., and sister Ashley. Quincy has played football for 4 years, including 3 at Tucker. After graduation, Quincy plans to play football for a college in-state and major in business. Antez Starks II is escorted by his father and coach Antez Sr. and sister Jamia. Antez has played football for 10 years, including 4 years at Tucker. After graduation, he plans to go to college and get a degree and play in the NFL. Jackson Pickett is escorted by his mother Shauna and father Marvin and his brother Jacob. Jackson has played football for 13 years, including 4 at Tucker, where he is also on the track and field team as a thrower. After graduation, Jackson plans to play football in college and major in kinesiology and become a chiropractor. Inde Moss. He's escorted by his mother, Wandrea, and his Mimi Ruby, and his grandmother, Bessie. Inde has played football for 10 years, including 2 years at Tucker. Inde is a member of FBLA, and after graduation, plans to earn a college degree. Akil Malik is escorted by his mother Angela and his father Sharif and his older sister Sahura. Akil has played football for 13 years, including 3 at Tucker. Akil has lettered in track and field as a thrower. After graduation, Akil plans to attend an HBCU and major in computer and software engineering. Up next, our cheerleader, Serenity Butler. She's escorted by her mother, Sequoia, and little sister, Bebe. Serenity has cheered at Tucker for 2 years and has been on the track team. Serenity has earned a 3.5 GPA, and after graduation, plans to become an ultrasound sonographer. Elena Good is escorted by her mother Tiffany and stepfather Thomas and her siblings. Elena has cheered at Tucker for 3 years and also on the track and field team. She is cheer co-captain and member of the Health Occupation Students of America Club. After graduation, Elena plans to go to medical school and earn her BSN and degree in pediatric nursing. Jaden Joyner is escorted by her mother Tonya and her father Mark and her brother Adam. Jaden has cheered at Tucker for 3 years and is also on the JV and varsity soccer team, varsity track and field team, and varsity flag football team. She is a member of the IB Diploma Program, National Honor Society, Beta Club, Senior Class Parliamentarian for Student Council and Student Council Officer. She's earned a 4.8 GPA and plans to attend a college and major in Humanities and Political Science. Leah Mosley is escorted by her mother, Constanza, and her father, Luther, and her sister, Brianna. Leah has cheered for Tucker for 3 years. She is a member of Skills USA, cheer captain in the IB program. After graduation, Leah plans to attend Savannah State and continue to cheer. Akria Parker is escorted by her mother, Leticia, and her father, Frank, and grandmother, Diane. Akria has cheered at Tucker for 3 years and is cheer captain. She is also a member of the Tucker High School Chorus. After graduation, she plans to attend Kennesaw State University and major in business. We have the twins, Brooke and Brianna Davis. They are escorted by their father, Brett, mother, Janelle, older sister, Brittany, and grandparents. Brooke has cheered at Tucker for 3 years and is a member of the National Honor Society Beta Club Star IB program. Brooke has earned a 3.9 GPA and plans to attend an HBCU and major in radiology. Brianna has been in Brand for 3 years, is a member of Beta Club, National Honor Society, STAR, and HOSA. After graduation, Brianna plans to attend Albany State University and major in sonography. Anna Burkett Barrett. She is escorted by Hooray, Gerber Michael, and Nardos Tespe. Anna has been in the band for 4 years. She is president of the National Honor Society, co-president of STAR, editor-in-chief of the yearbook, and senior class president. After graduation, Anna plans to attend a 4-year university and major in psychology. Nevia Castillo is escorted by Omar Castillo and Ona Terlinger. Nevia has been in band for 6 years. Nevia is a member of FCCLA and plans to attend Jackson State University and major in music production. Shay Collins is escorted by Nicole Collins. Shay has been in band for 2 years. Shay is a member of Junior ROTC, Skills USA, and the Tucker High School Step Team. After graduation, Shay plans to attend an HBCU and major in criminal justice. Davis Duchin is escorted by Brett and Sandy Duchin. Davis has been in band for 6 years. After graduation, David plans to attend college and major in music education. Yassine Farley is escorted by Jessica Farley. Yassine has been in band for 1 year. After graduation, Yassine plans to attend college and major in music production. Mia Freeze. Mia is escorted by John and Julie Freeze. Mia has been in band for 4 years. After graduation, she plans to attend college and major in journalism with a minor in music technology. Michelle Garcia. She's escorted by her parents, Sergio and Carmen Garcia. Michelle has been in band for 1 year and is a member of Habitat for Humanity, HOSA, and the National Honor Society. After graduation, Michelle plans to go to college and major in biomedical engineering. Dietrich Howard is escorted by Thomas Palmer and Amanda Howard. Dietrich has been in band for 1 year. After graduation, Dietrich plans to attend an HBCU and major in criminal justice. Jordan Jones is escorted by Renee and Amanda Jones. Jordan has been in band for 2 years and is also a member of the Tucker High School Chorus. After graduation, Jordan plans to attend Texas Southern University and major in psychology and criminal justice. Nathaniel Lawrence. Nathaniel is escorted by his parents, Brian and Laurel Lawrence. Nathaniel has been in band for 6 years. After graduation, he plans to attend college and play in the band. Akilah Lapai is escorted by Grace Lapai. Akilah has been in band for 3 years. After graduation, he plans to get a college degree. Arsima Mulageta is escorted by Sunny Mulageta. Arsima has been in band for 1 year and is a member of HOSA, Tucker High School Step Team, Debate Team, FBLA, and Student Government. After graduation, Arsima plans to go to college and major in nursing. Kennedy Richards is escorted by Justin Richards and Cherish Kroom. Kennedy has been in band for 3 years. After graduation, she plans to attend Alabama A&M University and major in elementary education. Mackenzie Robinson is escorted by Willie and Cassandra Robinson. Mackenzie has been in band for 3 years. After graduation, he plans to attend Jackson State and major in business with a minor in music. Sergio May Romero is escorted by parents Jose Luis and Castilla Romero. Sergio has been in band for 3 years and is a member of National Honor Society, Beta Club, FCLA, Hope, and Habitat for Humanity. After graduation, Sergio plans to attend college and major in civil engineering. Raylene Simpson is escorted by Monica Griffin. Raylene has been in band for 1 year and is a member of Tucker High School Chorus. She plans to attend Payne College and major in business administration. Trius Trewold is escorted by Chauncey Bailey and Sarit Tewold. Trius has been in band for 1 year and is also on the track and field team. LaShawn Woods Jr. is escorted by his parents, LaShawn and Joy Woods. LaShawn has been in band for 4 years. After graduation, LaShawn plans to attend college and major in music. And last but not least, Joyce Yabadi. Our last senior has been escorted by Sedone Bivaloa. Joyce has been in band for 1 year and is also a member of Habitat for Humanity and Junior ROTC. After graduation, Joyce plans to attend college and major in biochemistry. Congrats to all our seniors. Thank you, parents, teachers, everybody who's here, and congratulations on their accomplishment. Let's go, Tigers!
Do I still have my Ram fans out here? Do we still have our Tucker fans out here? Are you ready for the second half? Before we get started, Coach Tucker, Coach, can I get some volunteer parents for the team? Officials need help with the team. About ready for the second half. Are you ready? Are you ready? I can't hear you. And Tucker will be kicking off. Elijah Frank on the kickoff.
Thank you.
again in the line, and he ran into a wall, but he was able to fall forward to the 50 for a first down. Corey to the outside again. He's looking for room down the line. Goes down at about the 34. First down. Thank you. scrimmage on that. It'll be third down. Pick up a first down on that run. First down, Ram. Second and eight. And the flag on the play. They looking, got a man in. No flag. That'll to bring up third down and about 13 for the Rams. Looking, has nowhere to go. And the Tiger hold. The fourth down kicking for the Rams. And now he runs, and he kills up, and it mows his way all the way to a first down. Let's see what the flag is about. Personal foul against the Rams. That was tacked on extra yardage. Ram on the quarterback run, muffled his way to a first down. Plus extra yardage for a personal foul. Taking the ball all the way to the 47 yard line. First down for the Tigers. Graham again looking, running the ball. Drug down after about 3 yards. Pick up. 4 yards on that run. With 102 left in the third quarter, we have a tie game, 14-14. With the Rams and the Tigers. Take over. With the beginning of the fourth quarter, we have a barn burn here. But let's give a round of applause for our young people, the Radio Mountain Band and cheerleaders, doing an outstanding job tonight. Also, let's give a round of applause for the Tucker Tigers, cheerleaders and band. These young folks keep us moving and stay warm in this chilly night. And first down for the Rams on their own 20-yard line.
Okay, Johnny. Okay, Johnny. Okay, Johnny. Johnny. Johnny.
He's still up. Moving. And they were pushed out of bounds at about the 44. Jonathan O'Day. Run by Jones. Can I hear my Arabian Mountain fans out there? What about my Tucker Tiger fans? Are you out there? Thank you. incomplete. Got two receivers in the area. Couldn't hit him. Third down and goal for the Rams. Quarterback keep again, and he is stopped. For McCoy, you lost yards on that play. Bringing up second down, a little more than 10 for first. Thank you.
recorded. No, still not working.
Graham dropping back, looking, looking. Got a man over there. And caught at the 20-yard line. Christian Whitmore again. He's been having an outstanding night tonight. Ball placed on the 19, first down for the Tigers. McCoy spins out, trying looking for room. Good 6-yard run for McCoy. That'll bring up second down. McCoy again up the middle. First down. Graham decided to pick off. And he was caught right there at about the 7. It'll be third down and goal. Mark a halfway to the goal, offside on the Ram. They're trying to get a jump. Third and goal. Ram try to keep it. And the Ram. Back him up. The Ram thinks they fumbled the ball. Call from the official yet.
That way!
And the Tigers were able to maintain the ball. And fourth down. And timeout by the Tigers. Fourth down, 3:50 left in the game. And the Rams up 17-14 with the Tigers driving. Getting down to the end. 17-17 with 3:46 left in the game. A battle of the Titans.
Thank you.
motion on the offense. Got to take them back time. Making it a difference for the third down. .144 left in the quarter, and the Rams are kicking to the Tigers. Cover. Andy with 1:36 left, the Tigers are on their own 40-yard line. They tried to score and go into overtime. Play to go. Looking for a man. He got one wide open. Oh, he's good.
Scrub. Yeah, scrub.
He's complete.
Grab that knockout. Scrub, City. Scrub. Seatbelt. Seatbelt. Boy, he took his ass on a ride. Seatbelt.
What they do to the rim? What the rim do?
Yeah, we're in people down.
QB Marcus. What was that prediction, QB Marcus? Hey, hey, QB Marcus.
Hey, shut the fuck
up. Eddie, what are you doing?
I think away.
All heart and mind goes out for the future on the field. Fourth down and 10. 37 seconds left in the game.
Thank you.
another try. And we look as though we are going into overtime.
Let me know if I can help you with anything.
Just looking. I only buy local and sustainable, so.
Oh, well, that shirt's not local. You should be wearing cotton. Georgia's a major supplier of cotton worldwide, so if you'd like to buy local to support Georgia, buying cotton's a great place to start. It's renewable and sustainable, naturally.
Thanks.
Now, that's a polyester fiber made of oil, by the way.
Where's your dressing room?
At Regions Bank, we're here to listen to your needs, and we'll customize a plan to help you reach your financial goals. Our service to Georgia goes beyond banking to creating more inclusive prosperity in our communities. From education to financial wellness to economic development, we're working to level the playing field so more people can succeed and our communities can thrive. Thank you.
flag comes out.
Touchdown!
court around the end.
Let me know if I can help you with anything.
Just looking. I only buy local and sustainable, so.
Oh, well, that shirt's not local. You should be wearing cotton. Georgia's a major supplier of cotton worldwide, so if you'd like to buy local to support Georgia, buying cotton's a great place to start. It's renewable and sustainable, naturally.
Thanks.
Now, that's a polyester fiber made of oil, by the way.
Where's your dressing room?
At Regions Bank, we're here to listen to your needs, and we'll customize a plan to help you reach your financial goals. Our service to Georgia goes beyond banking to creating more inclusive prosperity in our communities. From education to financial wellness to economic development, we're working to level the playing field so more people can succeed and our communities can thrive.